What's up, YouTubers? It's Sunday again, and I got my circadian rhythm all messed up again. Over again. Excuse me. So I'd just like to make this video to to let you guys know that I'm still breathing, at least, thank God. I'm still not in a holding cell, thank God. I still can log on to YouTube to upload this video, at least for now, thank God. And I still have a Bible, thank God. So if you have anything on top of your raiment, aka your clothing and food, you should be thankful. You should remain thankful and continue to praise the Lord and stop complaining about shit that much. Well, certainly complaining about shit and non-shit every now and then won't hurt that much, but you certainly won't want to waste much of your time mostly on complaining, right? You should, as men, especially us, we men, we ought to spend more time doing things, making things happen, instead of complaining about things not happening, yeah? So that's men. That's a completely manly and masculine and honorable thing to make something happen. Yes, as men. Whilst the opposite sex more often than not complains about things not happening to them, to, you know, in their own terms, since they did not put in the right amount of effort, the right amount of hard work to make something aligning with their interest and the desire happen. So bear that in mind. Also, I suppose I also have a message. I have a message to young couples. Just in case you think about bearing or having any children. Once you made up your mind, and then you let that thing happen, you pop out some children, some human individual infants. Stop complaining, and once they grow into adult human individuals, and they start rebelling against your will, your command you added to them, you shouldn't complain that much, since you made such decision to bring them into this world, and it was completely up to you to bring them to this world. You have a choice. You have a choice to make precautions in terms of contraceptions, in terms of personal choices. You know, you have the free will. You have the space to, you have the such free space to maneuver, to choose things to occur, you know, in your own terms, to a certain extent. Though I'm not saying we have complete control over our minds, soul, and flesh, but yes, we do have choice. We do have free room, you know, free will to make certain choices, to make something happen, something not happen. Since, you know, Just for your information, in the book of Deuteronomy, free, you know, the word free will appeared, you know, more than just a couple of times. So feel free to read it. Feel free to check it out. But that says you have to look it up on KJV, on KJV Bible, not other versions, since those versions are perversions instead of the right version. So I hope I have made my points clear, and I hope you are currently enjoying your Sunday with, you know, with people whom you love and care about. Unlike me, you know, I just had in fact, you know, some sort of a nightmare. It's nothing comparable to a horrible nightmare, though yet it keeps haunting and bothering me, since, you know, the you know, pretty much the same pattern, you know, the same plot occurs to me more than dozens times over than I care to remember, than I care to complain about. You know, I often have dreams, like, you know, where I go somewhere all by myself, and I have and the weather kind of appears bleak and grim, and I myself wandering over the streets and whatnot, and then I got lost, and blah blah blah, and yada yada yada. But well, it's perhaps I should consult with my psychiatrist in regards to such problem. Nevertheless, I'm not trying to make complaining. The main topic of this filming session, the main topic of this particular video. So, in any regard, stay thankful, stay grateful, remain steadfast, stay safe, stay put, and have faith. I hope to see you guys next time on YouTube. So I will try. Since I got my circadian rhythm all messed up again, I might start cold calling some more people tonight. So stay tuned for my latest cold call vids. And for those who stutter, perhaps you should learn to make cold calls. You should learn to read the Bible. You should learn to read as much as you can. You know, I suppose that's a great way to mitigate, if not completely overcome, your stuttering. So, but in any regard, I have talked enough in this film session. So anyway, thanks again for watching, and I hope to see you guys next time on YouTube, if God's still willing. Cheers and take care. Bye bye.